Welcome to part 5 of your module 3. Okay. In today's part, we shall study about Poisson distribution. In part 4, in previous part, you studied about binomial distribution. Both binomial and Poisson distribution are discrete distributions. That means corresponding random variables are discrete random variables. Once again, recall, for binomial distribution, which of the terms are required? We need n. N means number of trials. P means probability of success and Q means probability of failure. If n and p are known, we can answer any question under binomial distribution. Okay. So today we shall study about Poisson distribution. Now actually Poisson distribution is regarded as limiting form of binomial distribution. Okay, only that is the difference. Mainly when number of trials in binomial distribution is very large, if n is more than 30, we take it as a large value. Okay, if n is very large, in general we take n tends to infinity, and if probability of success p, small letter p, is very small, we generally take it as p tends to 0. Okay, in these two cases the binomial distribution tends to Poisson distribution. And as n tends to infinity and p tends to 0, that product n into p always remains a constant. That constant is denoted by lambda. Okay. So lambda is always n into p. So using these conditions, I am directly giving you the PDF of Poisson distribution. PDF is given by probability of capital X equal to small x or p of x equal to e raised to minus lambda, lambda to the power x divided by x factorial. Here lambda is a parameter which is given by n into p. And what are the values taken by x here? Once again, this is obtained by using n Bernoulli trials where n tends to infinity. Okay. So when you perform n Bernoulli trials, a large number of Bernoulli trials, how many successes are possible? Meaning is same here as in the case of binomial distribution. X is number of successes. So out of a large number of trials, how many successes are possible? Clearly you can write either 0 successes or 1 success or 2 successes like this. I am not giving you the upper limit here. It depends on your large value of n. So in general, we take it as till infinity. N tends to infinity. So n trials means we take till infinity. Okay. And this p of x is also called as Poisson probability function. And x is also called as a Poisson variate. Remember, sometimes in the question problems, they may give you the term x is a Poisson variate. That means it is understood that x satisfies or x follows Poisson distribution. And you don't have the derivations. Directly you remember these formulae. Mean of Poisson distribution is given by lambda. Variance of Poisson distribution is again lambda. So remember, a distribution where both mean and variances are equal is nothing but Poisson distribution. So remember this PDF formula as well as mean and variance formula. In the case of binomial distribution, mean was n into p. Here the same n into p is equal to lambda. So in this case mean is lambda. In the binomial distribution, we need two parameters n and p. But Poisson distribution depends on only one parameter lambda. Okay, remember this. Now let us work out some problems. Start with the simple problem. This is a very simple problem. We can say that it is a one mark question. If mean of Poisson distribution is 2, find p of x equal to 0. Okay. So given distribution, name is given, Poisson distribution. If distribution is Poisson, you have the formula. P of x equal to x equal to e raised to minus lambda, lambda to the power x by x factorial. And what is mean? Mean of the Poisson distribution is 2. You know that mean of Poisson distribution is given by lambda. So lambda is 2. So once if you know the value of lambda, as I told you, Poisson distribution depends on only one parameter, lambda. So once if you know the value of lambda, you can directly substitute the value of lambda here. So what is probability of x equal to 0? Required answer equal to e raised to minus lambda, lambda value is 2, and lambda to the power x, lambda to the power 0, 2 to the power 0, divided by 0 factorial. Directly use your calculator, answer is 0.1353. Very simple question, just to understand the meaning of this lambda and required probability, this question is given. One more simple problem. In a Poisson distribution, if p of x equal to 3 is same as p of x equal to 2, find p of x equal to 0. Okay, here they have not given the mean value, that means parameter value lambda, but distribution is mentioned. Distribution is Poisson and these two probabilities are equal. So what you have to do now? First start from the PDF of Poisson distribution. In general, what is the PDF of Poisson distribution? We know that p of x equal to e raised to minus lambda, lambda to the power x by x factorial. This is the PDF. And where x varies from 0 to infinity, you can write where x equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. It continues in that way. Now, p of x equal to 3, you can find using this formula. Similarly, p of x equal to 2, you can find using this formula. Okay, substitute this p of x equal to 3 values and p of x equal to 2 values and equate them. So when you use the formula for x equal to 3 and x equal to 2 and equate them, you get this equation. E raised to minus lambda, lambda cube by 3 factorial equal to e raised to minus lambda, lambda square by 2 factorial. Simplify further. E raised to minus lambda being a common term, it cancels. Remaining even lambda cube and lambda square, you can cancel lambda square on both sides. So which are the remaining terms now? Only one lambda term here, divided by 3 factorial is 6, and here 1 by 2. Other terms are cancelled. So that means lambda equal to 3. So using this equality, we are finding the value of mean. That means lambda. And once if lambda value is known, you can find any probability. So you can find p of x equal to 0. Formula is e raised to minus lambda, lambda to the power 0 by 0 factorial. In this formula, we put lambda value and x value. X value is 0. And lambda value is 3. Just now you obtained. Okay, substitute. And use the calculator. Answer will be 0.0497. So our next example, given that 2% of fuses manufactured by a firm are defective, find by using Poisson distribution the probability that a box containing 200 fuses has no defective fuses. The first question. Second question, 3 or more defective fuses. And your third question, at least one defective fuse. Once again, name of the distribution is mentioned here, Poisson distribution. Okay. And take here number of defective fuses, the probability of defective fuses is asked. So take success as getting a defective fuse. So probability of success, our notation is small letter p. It is nothing but probability of a defective fuse. And this probability is given 2%. 2% means actually it is in terms of real number, it is 0.02. 2 divided by 100, you get 0.02. So you can observe that p is a small number. And n, number of fuses, is 200. N equal to 200. When n is large and p is small, even if the method is not mentioned, always we prefer Poisson distribution. Okay, sometimes they may give you the problem without mentioning the distribution. So you decide the distribution correctly. Here n is large. If n is more than 30, we take it as large. Okay. So here n is large, 200, and p is small. So we shall use Poisson distribution. But for Poisson distribution, we require only one parameter, lambda. Find that mean number of defectives, lambda is given by n into p. So 200 into 0.02, which gives you 4. Now, after getting lambda, start from the Poisson distribution, PDF. What is your PDF of Poisson distribution? P of x equal to lambda to the power x e raised to minus lambda divided by x factorial. Substitute, you get 4 raised to x, lambda is 4. 4 raised to x by into e raised to minus 4 divided by x factorial. Now go to the questions. So your PDF is known now. First question, what is the probability that box containing 200 fuses has no defective fuses? No defective fuses. I have taken success as x equal to number of defective fuses. I have not mentioned here. You can write one extra condition here. Let x equal to in the beginning. Let x equal to number of defective fuses. So no defective fuses means x will be 0. So probability of no defective fuse is p of 0. P of x formula is known. Just put x equal to 0 and calculate. You get 0.0183. Second question. 3 or more defective fuses. So what are the values of x now? 3 or more. That means 3 is included and more. So x greater than or equal to 3 is the notation for this. At least one defective. Third question. At least one defective means x is greater than or equal to 1. Least value is 1. Other values are greater values. So greater than or equal to 1. So I am giving you these two sub questions now. Second question. 3 or more means p of x greater than or equal to 3. Here it is preferable to use the complementary event. Otherwise, greater than or equal to 3 means till 3 to 200 you need to list. So instead of that, I am using the complementary event. It is equal to 1 minus p of x less than 3. See the notation, greater than or equal to 3. So equality is included here. You should not include equality here. It is strictly less than 3. In discrete case, less than and less than or equal to, you have the difference. Substitute now. X less than 3 means possible values are p of x equal to 0 plus p of x equal to 1 plus p of x equal to 2. And p of x formula is obtained here. P of x formula. In this formula, put x equal to 0, x equal to 1 and x equal to 2. You get this. And use the calculator. You can use calculation yourself. No need to write the same steps. Just use the calculator. Write your own calculation steps. And finally, this calculation gives you the answer 0.7621. Just check it. So no need to use the same steps. You can use your own method. Here actually e raised to minus 4 is common term. It is taken out. That answer is written here. And remaining terms are written inside the bracket. You get 0.7621. Third question. Okay, actually third question is not answered here. What is the third question? At least one defective fuse. At least one means p of x greater than or equal to 1. Greater than or equal to 1 means you have the complementary event. It is equal to 1 minus p of x less than 1. Greater than or equal to 1. Its complementary event is p of x less than 1. Less than 1 means you have only one possibility. X equal to 0. So actually answer for third question will be 1 minus p of 0. So you will get 1 minus this answer. Okay. Just calculate and find out 1 minus this answer. I have not worked out here. So our next problem is, in a certain factory turning out razor blades, there is a small probability of 1 by 500 for any blade to be defective. The blades are supplied in packets of 10. Use Poisson distribution to calculate the approximate number of packets containing no defective, one defective, two defectives in a consignment of 10,000 packets. So read the question carefully. Probability of defective. So you can take success as getting defective blade. So let x equal to number of defective blades, number of successes. Our general notation x for number of successes. And p means probability of success. So what is the success here? Defective. So probability of defective blade. It is given 1 by 500, which is 0.002. And n is given 10. Blades are supplied in packets of 10. Okay, before deciding n value, okay, some students take this as n value by mistake. Just see the question properly. What is the question asked? Use the Poisson distribution to calculate approximate number of packets. Approximate number of packets. That means probability is not the required answer. Number of packets is required. So what you have to do? Number of packets is required means, for one packet, what is the probability with these three conditions? Probability of no defective, one defective and two defectives in one packet. First find that probability percentage, then multiply by the number of packets. So in one packet, I am giving it as a side heading here. In one packet, what is the value of n? N equal to 10. So don't take this as n. In one packet, n equal to number of blades, 10. And p is given, n is given. So you can always find n into p. Usually, when n and p are given, you can also work out the problem under binomial distribution. Binomial distribution, you need only n and p values, two parameters. But here method is mentioned, Poisson distribution. Okay, one reason. And another reason, probability is very small. Usually when probability is very small and n is very large, we use Poisson distribution. But here n is not large number, p is very small. Okay, so when method is not mentioned, it is left to you. You can use any method. Here method is given, Poisson distribution. So we shall use only Poisson distribution. So you need lambda value, lambda equal to n into p. Calculate, you get 0.02. And once if you know the value of lambda, you can write the PDF, Poisson distribution, which is e raised to minus lambda, lambda to the power x by x factorial. Substitute your lambda value here, you get the PDF. And this PDF is a function of x, it is in terms of x. Now go to your first question. Calculate the approximate number of packets containing no defective. So in one packet means probability of x equal to 0. Then multiply by the number of packets. So in one packet these are the values. In 10,000 packets, in a consignment of 10,000 packets, number of packets with no defective is given by 10,000 into p of x equal to 0. P of x equal to 0 you can calculate easily by substituting in the PDF here. You put x equal to 0. Calculate, you can use any method for calculation. Anyway, you are using the calculator. So I have not written the steps. You get the answer 9802. Remember, here the required answer is number of packets. So even if you get a fraction answer, 9801 point something, just to check whether that fraction is near to 9802. Okay, so here I have written the rounded value directly. Okay, you may get 9801 point something. If that fraction is near to 9802, we write the nearest integer. Second question, number of packets with the one defective. This is actually second question, question number 2. Number of packets with one defective. In one packet, percentage of one defective is P of x equal to 1. then multiply by the number of packets, 10,000. Find the probability. 10,000 into in one packet, this is the probability. Just put x equal to 1 in your PDF. Calculate. Okay, I have written the answer 196. Check whether it is exactly 196 or 195 point something. I have written the nearest integer value. Okay. And number of packets with the two defectives is given by 10,000 into probability of x equal to 2. Same procedure. Now put x equal to 2 and calculate. See the number. Out of 10,000 packets, number of defectives with no defective. So no defective blades at all. That will be 9,802 packets. Okay. And out of 10,000 packets, number of packets with one defective blade is 196. And out of 10,000 packets, number of packets with the two defective blades, that is only 2. See the percentage. Because they have given, the percentage of defective is very less here. 1 divided by 500. 1 out of 500. Okay. So that chance is very less. Here number is very less. A very good example which is asked in your model question paper and also appeared in old question papers. A slight different type of question. A car hire firm has two cars which it hires out on a day-to-day basis. The number of demands for a car is known to be Poisson distribution with the mean 1.5. Find the probability of day on which there is no demand for the car and the demand is rejected. Okay. So directly the required probability is not given in terms of x. Instead of that, condition is given here. Okay. The car hire firm has two cars. So there are two cars in the firm. So n equal to 2. The demands for a car is Poisson distribution. So demands for a car follows Poisson distribution means x is taken as number of demands for a car. You can take x equal to, here you can write equal to sign. Let x equal to number of demands for a car. And mean value of the demand is given. Mean is 1.5. Lambda is 1.5. So once if the value of lambda is known, you can write the Poisson distribution. P of x is equal to 1.5 to the power x e raised to minus lambda 1.5 divided by x factorial. This is the PDF of Poisson distribution with the lambda equal to 1.5. Directly I have given the PDF here. Now what is the question? Find the probability that there is no demand for a car. The probability of a day on which there is no demand for the car. So number of demands will be 0. There is no demand means number of demands. Every probability required you convert it to x in terms of x. So x will be 0. So required answer is only P of 0. Directly put x equal to 0 in your expression for P of x. Calculate. You get 0.2231. Second question. The demand is rejected. When you say that a demand is rejected, okay, the car hire firm has only two cars. So when the firm will reject some demands, if the number of demands will be more than 2, available cars are only 2, if number of demands is more than 2, then clearly the car hire firm has to reject the demand because no extra cars are available. So instead of this, actually condition here is probability of x greater than 2. Remember, so instead of giving x, they have given the condition. So the demand will be rejected if number of demands is more than number of available cars. So required probability is P of x greater than 2, strictly greater than 2. Okay. That means 1 minus P of x less than or equal to 2 using the complementary event here. Substitute 1 minus p of x less than or equal to 2 means you have 3 possibilities: x equal to 0, x equal to 1 and x equal to 2. And for each value of x, substitute in your PDF which you have written here, probability density function, and calculate. You can use your own calculation steps. You get the answer 0.1912. Okay, that means in terms of percentage, if you write this, it will be 19.12%. When you are writing in terms of percentage, we multiply this by 100. That means 19.12%. So 19% chances are there for the rejection of the demand. Anyway, it is enough if you write the answer in terms of real number like this. And recall the property of probability. Every probability will be greater than 0 and less than 1. It lies in between 0 and 1. A very good question. Next question. This is actually similar to your worked out problem. Only for your practice I have included here. The number of accidents in a year to taxi drivers in a city follows a Poisson distribution with the mean 3. So which follows Poisson distribution? We take that as x. So take x equal to number of accidents in a year for taxi drivers. You can include the full sentence. And mean is given, lambda equal to 3. And given that x follows Poisson distribution, these are the given conditions. Now using lambda, mean, you can write the Poisson distribution. It is e raised to minus lambda, lambda to the power x by x factorial. Substitute the value of lambda. This gives you the PDF in terms of lambda. Okay, actually for lambda to the power x, you can write here 3 to the power x. I have not substituted for this lambda. Here also you can substitute. It is e raised to minus 3 into 3 to the power x by x factorial. Now what is the question asked? Out of 1000 taxi drivers, find the number of drivers. So required answer is a number, not probability. So what you have to do? For one taxi driver, what is the chance? Here I have given the side heading already. For one driver, what is the chance of these accidents? No accident, more than 3 accidents. Then later you can multiply by 1000. So you have to find the probability and multiply by 1000. So here I have given out of 1000 drivers, directly I have given the side heading, number of drivers with no accidents in a year. That means 1000 into probability of 0 accidents, P of 0. Calculate, you have the PDF given, substitute in the PDF and calculate. And since the required answer is number of drivers, even if you get fraction, you cannot keep the answer in terms of fraction because number of drivers cannot be fraction. So we write the nearest integer. 49.78 means nearest integer is 50. So if this after decimal point, if you have 5 or more than 5, we write the next integer. Second question, similar. Number of drivers with more than 3 accidents in a year. For 3 accidents, percentage is P of x greater than 3, more than 3. Then multiply by 1000, number of drivers. So you get the number of drivers with the more than 3 accidents. Once again here, it is better to use the complementary event. Okay, greater than 3 means you cannot list all the values, 4, 5, 6, etc. You have to list. So instead of that, you go for complementary event. P of x less than or equal to 3. 1 minus P of x less than or equal to 3. Substitute in your PDF and calculate. And e raised to minus 3 is a common term in all the 4 terms. After substituting, you can check it. I have not shown the substitution step here. That is taken out and that value is 0.0498. And remaining terms are written inside the bracket. You can use your own steps for calculation. Just calculate this. You will get nearest integer value as 350. So what is the meaning? Out of 1000 drivers, number of drivers with more than 3 accidents in a year is 350. Okay. Just a practice problem for you. Now in this session we worked out problems under Poisson distribution. And in the previous session, we worked out problems under binomial distribution. Okay, I will give you some more problems in the next session, but I will not mention you the name of the distribution. You have to decide the distribution properly and then work out the problem. Okay, in all the problems which are worked out today, the name of the distribution was mentioned, Poisson. So if name is mentioned, you can't change the method. But if name is not mentioned, how to decide the method? That I will give you in the next session. Thank you.